Hello, I'm Mr. Arnett here, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, teaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity, Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. I can explain parables to the very bottom, and most of the people of the book, they only understand what is written in the book. If the gospel could be written in ink on paper, then Jesus need not to come. He could have dictated this thing to a scribe for you to read. It is not so. They are in parables because only those people who have a discerning intellect, capable of logical reasoning, only they find it. Others just read it like novel. They get next to nothing. And here I'm doing a gospel according to Matthew 3, verse 13 to 17. Then the holy gospel of our supernatural father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, that means all the same thing, etc., delivered by Jesus, the first anointed Christ of the Most High Living God Elohim, that dwells within us, called Emmanuel, according to Saint Matthew 3, verse 30 to 17. Then Jesus came from Galilee to John at the Jordan to be baptized by him. John tried to prevent him, saying, I need to be baptized by you, and yet you are coming to me. Now this is, most people don't understand that John the Baptist, he was a witness to the light, but not the light. And so he was not the primary source of light, but Jesus was. And so he was like a moon, John the Baptist, and Jesus was sun, the primary source of light. So this is the moonlight fall on this one, sunlight on our heart. So the sunlight is greater than moonlight. If there is no sunlight, moonlight can't shine. But without moon, light has no value. So that's why Jesus wanted to fulfill that first you have to be son of man before you could be son of God. So although the baptism of water is the base, is the fundamental, yet you cannot be the son of the Most High Elohim unless you are a son of your tribal father or of man. In Adam we have races, in their races we have tribes, and all that, subdivision to your surname. So if you can build your covenant to Adam or to your forefathers, then you are a son of man. This earth, planet earth, is for the sons of man and not for Hindu, Sikh, Christian, Muslim or Jew. They are spiritual self. Nothing to do with the secular world. You can see how these riots are creating in the Middle East because of the fanatics created by the Most High sons of Satan, mullahs. So, Elohim and Allah, unless you are a son of your tribal father or of man, you cannot be son of the Most High. Such people have the salt of their tribal forefathers. Remember that Jacob had 12 sons. 11 were crook, and they wanted to get rid of the Joseph, who was honest and truthful. So they sold him as a slave to the Egyptian. And as soon as Joseph, who was the salt of Abraham, who had the qualities of Abraham, as soon as he left the promised land became barren because none was faithful to Abraham or to Yahweh, who planted Abraham in that promised land. And you could remember the story of exile and all that. You know, Jesus told this story in the parable of the prodigal son, Isaac, and how they left the country to another land, and how they suffered, and Moses brought them back. The same land became lush green. Much more I have put in the videos. So salt of their tribal forefather, which is called HEEYA. In Arabic they call it HEEYA, and Hazrat Muhammad Sahib said HEEYA is a half faith, nisaf iman. Nisaf mean half. And in Punjabi we call it Sharm, and in English we call it conscience, a man of conscience, you know, etc. Or no Sharm, no Dharm. No conscience, no salt of the man, and no faith in God, but in Satan. Now John the Baptist was baptizing chosen men, especially of the Judah tribe, who by becoming Jews outwardly had broken their tribal covenant with Abraham. Abraham was not a Jew. He was of Semitic race outwardly. So when they became Jew outwardly, they break their covenant with Abraham, and by breaking it, they became super bastard fanatic devils. And thus, the Jews, no Sharm. Now John the Baptist was baptizing chosen men, especially of the Judah tribe, who by becoming Jews outwardly, from Judah to Judaism, Judaism to Jew outwardly, had broken their tribal covenant with Abraham, and thus became the super bastard fanatic devils. John 8 verse 44, and also in Matthew 19 verse 12, Jesus described the three types of eunuchs, which I tell you, for there are eunuchs who were born that way. These are the bastards born of the prostitutes and temple dassies. You know, the bastards, they are not allowed to marry because they will reproduce more. People who have no tribal identity. So in the past, you know, these, they used to devote their life to the worship of God. And Jesus called them mustard seed. And they became big saint, you know. And the great sensible people went to listen to their discourses. Birds of the air went and roosted on the big tree. And there are eunuchs who have been made eunuchs by others, made by men, you know, as the temple priest. They told the Jews, people of Judah tribe, now you are no more Judah tribe, you are Jew outwardly. As the Mohammedan these days go to Kaaba, and over there the Mullah will tell them, no, don't put your surname behind it. Now you are no surname, you are all alike. A man without surname, he is a bastard. A bastard born of the prostitute, she doesn't know whose son he is. But people know their son, know their father. And when they renounce their tribal identity, they become bastards worse than those born of the prostitutes. This Jesus told in John 8, verse 44. To this they replied that we are not born of the fornication. We have legitimate parents. Jesus said, what you say is true. But by becoming Jew outwardly, you have broken your covenant with Abraham, because Abraham was of Semitic race and not a Jew. These are those, the one made by eunuchs by others. These are those who have replaced their tribal identity with the religious, such as Jew, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian, etc. You know, these, all these. And those who are head of these organizations, they are called the son, they are the, called the sons of the Most High Satan, Al-Djmar Al-Aksa. Al-Djmar Al-Aksa itself, when you go to the Hajj, you know, there are these three pillars that represent these Satan, sons of Satan. You could throw 7 stone at them to repulse them. And this is in the West, you know. Satan is it is resting against a hillock or declining against a hillock. And the hillock is the of fanatic, super bastard fanatic devil. They are the hillock mountain. Wherever they go, they destroy the countries. Only thing that can stop them, if there is a son of man, they cannot harm him. So this war going on in Syria, and all this Shia-Sunni war going on, if they become sons of man, nobody can kill them. So far they are under the influence of their mullahs. Mullahs are Al-Djmar Al-Aksas, sons of the Most High Satan. Because in Islam, you have to give your own account to Allah. Islam is submission to the will of Allah, not to the will of mullah, which is Inshmullah. So this Islam is of Inshmullah, and you will see how they will suffer. Inshallah, Islam is of sun, primary source of light. Moon and star is of mullah. Much more I put in other videos. So when they are the head of their organization is religious, then he's the Satan called Al-Djmar Al-Aksa. When he's non-religious selves, such as conservative, labor, communist, etc., you know, Green Party and whatnot, they are not tribal. So that is called Al-Djmar Al-Kubra. So the Satan in the West, he had two names, Al-Djmar Al-Aksa, Al-Djmar Al-Kubra. Kubra being great. So they are called the tares, wheat and tares, parable of wheat and tares, Matthew 13. Today, you know, these tares, the Jews outwardly, they are getting bundled up in Israel for the final burning. So you will see a lot of tribulation in the world. And there are those who chose to live like eunuchs, as John the Baptist did, and Sadhus, you know, Sadhus in India, do for the sake of the royal kingdom of God. So the Sadhus, they leave their tribal homes and they go to jungle and wilderness to produce 100% fruit. Remember the parable of sower? Some seed fell on flat ground, rocky soil, and some on soil, but the worldly affair choked the fruit. So those who have knowledge, want to improve upon them, they used to go to wilderness and they used to preach gospel full time. I'm I can't preach gospel full time. So I'm the one who produced 60% fruit. Those who go to wilderness, they produce 100%. Are to put on the royal kingdom of God, are to put on Christ to be a perfect rabbi. You know, the rabbis, it is defined by in Matthew 13 verse 52, he is the owner of a house, which is synagogue, who bringeth forth treasures, old and new. Old is scripture, new are oral Torah, are his word. So this his word, they get it when they are in the wilderness. So John the Baptist, he was a prophet, but temple priest hated him. They don't want to know him. And John the Baptist spoke good, absolute truth. He told those temple priests, you are brood of vipers. Because when you become the head of the religious fanatic organization, then you make people to die, kill each other like that. As in India it happened 1947. Over there at that time my father was son of man. He knew the subject. So 2,000 people came to attack our village. And when my father told the attacking party that we tribal people going to kill each other, not Sikh and Muslim, they are spiritual self. He understood it. So he told the 2,000 to look after us as their guest, as they did. Whereas the rest of the India, they terrible. So Christ to be perfect rabbi, as Moses did. Moses put on Christ and wrote Torah. Same, the people can do it. Prophets deal with the moral laws, whilst the sons of the Most High with his word. His word, oral Torah, is the very source of the written Torah, because it is a reflection of the his word or the oral Torah. The one who can accept this should accept it. Not many people have ears to hear this. And you will find anyone who can explain what I have done to you. They have no idea of this thing. So gospel is for 1 in 1,000 and 2 in 10,000. And you can see how difficult it is. It is by grace. And it is so simple, easy, ABC, like ABC. But there is no interest among the people. So Jesus said to him in reply, allow it now for the sake of establishing the right path to Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. For no son of man, no son of God. That is the base, you know. If you have to be first son of man, then you could be son of God, because first know where our Father has given you the birth. You did not take birth, the soul, our supernatural self. It did not take birth at its own will, but by the will of our Father. So first accept that secular Father, and become son of man, have conscience, and then only you will be able to know the Most High, where you can perform his merciful deeds. So no son of man, no son of God, for thus it is fitting for us to fulfill all righteousness right to the door of our Father Elohim. Then John the Baptist, he allowed him, the second Adam, Yahshua. Jesus is called Yahshua. They stand for two words, Yah from Yahweh and Shua mean Adam. So the firstborn of Yahweh, second Adam. Mary was surrogate mother and Joseph a foster father. After Jesus was baptized in water in the name of his heavenly father Yahweh, he came up from the water, and behold, the heavens were opened for him, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and coming upon him. That is no son of man, no son of God, are Ba-Ilah, Ba-Allah. La-Ilah, as they go to Kaaba to say bye-bye to their tribal father, are to become super bastard fanatic devils. While they were in their villages and other things, they were sons of man, but they go to Kaaba, they keep the Kaaba to their left hand side. Left hand means I have given him away. I have thrown my illah away. La-Ilah means, this is what La-Ilah means. And they have become super bastard fanatic devils, and that is what they do. La-Ilah. So it is the Ba-Ilah, Ba-Allah. La-Ilah, Ba-Al-Djmar Al-Aksa. That means Satan, that is the Mullah. The Mullahs and Inshmullahs, the Fatwas. And a voice from Yahweh. Yahweh in heaven, our Father in heaven is Yahweh, the creator of male and female. His heavenly Father came from the heavens saying, this is my beloved Son Yahshua, with whom I am well pleased. That is, if you are faithful to your tribal father and heavenly father, Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda, etc., then he will feed and protect you from enemies, feed you as they did to the chosen people when they were faithful to Abraham and to Yahweh. This land was lush green, Garden of Edens. But as soon as they became unfaithful, the same land became barren. So as the Jews were unfaithful to Abraham and Yahweh, the land wasn't producing enough food as it used to be the Garden of Eden. And they, the anti-Semitic, were slaves to the Romans of better conscience. So anybody who has a good conscience is a man of God, and he rules over the people. Otherwise, people with evil spirit will make the people suffer. They will suck their blood. Same in India, Mughals, when they had good conscience, they ruled over India. But as they deteriorated, they were replaced by other people. So the British went there, and now we have got ourselves, and now the people ruling, original one, they are not good conscience. That's why bribery and corruption has gone up sky high. So these are the things. Greed is the one that kills people in this dark age. And the disparity between rich and poor reflects the conscience of the people. Samaritan villages, they did not have that disparity as the chosen people villages had. They had some rich and some poor, That's why poor Lazarus was at the gate of a rich man and looking forward to his bread from the table. So this thing, what happens? Remember when Jesus told the Pilate the truth, that what is inside, you should be outside. Otherwise, you will not be sitting on this throne. When Pilate asked him, what is truth? Then Jesus told him, what is inside you should be outside. And do not be hypocrite. If you have become hypocrite, you won't be sitting on this seat. And that is why he was frightened to say wrong thing. Then he said, this man has no fault. I find no fault guilty of him to be killed. But they were shouting at him, you know. And that shout, you know, when there were too much shout, then he said, okay, if you want him, take him away. And he went outside in the sun, washed his hand of the affair of Jesus, that now the blood of this man is on you. I have nothing to do with it, with that one. So sitting on the throne, he was frightened to do favor to the Jews, other than going out and washing his hand under sun, Elohim. Sun is Elohim, or Allah, or Parbrahm, that I have nothing to do with the blood of this righteous, innocent man. And the blood of curse, and the blood curse fell upon the Jews for killing him. Their temple was destroyed forever, and they suffered Holocaust in countries wherever the local had tribal instincts. So wherever the local had tribal instincts, they suffered Holocaust. They were killed. When English were English and not Labour and Conservative or so and so, they were persecuted. You know, they were persecuted, you know, killed. They persecuted the Jews. The same in Germany. When the Germans became Germans, they killed Jews. Whilst in America only, there was no tribal domination. They flourished among the tares. Much more in my videos on Hajj, in which the Abraham, Isaac story has been falsified, whilst the Abraham, Ishmael story is true. So you can see what they can do, you know. They falsified the scriptures and everything. So here you are. So I hope you enjoy it. And our Father God blesses you.